Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. We bless you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We honor you as Lord and Savior. Amen and amen. So, welcome. Welcome. If you have your Bibles, I want to speak to you on Isaiah 66. Two verses there, and then we will see what the Lord is saying. And you know I love shadows and types, all right? It means you are reading something in the Old Testament or New Testament, and then you look for Jesus Christ in that. And so, Isaiah 66. He was a most awesome prophet, but a prophet not like Elijah with miracles and stuff. He was a prophet that the prophecies and the understanding of Christ and Old Testament stuff was like, he was the most awesome prophet to understand things and spoke about things. So his knowledge was like just amazing of all the prophets, Isaiah. So Isaiah 66 verse 1, and you will see, yeah, I say anoint the footstool. Anoint the footstool. What is a footstool? All right, you put your feet on a stool. You rest your feet on a stool. That's a footstool. It says, this is what the Lord says. So this is what the Lord says. All right. Heaven is my throne. Heaven is my throne, and earth is my footstool. So I want to write that down because it's two things. Heaven is my throne. Now, the moment when we say heaven is my throne, throne speaks of authority. All right. The rulership is out of the heavens. And earth is my footstool. So earth is the footstool of God. The footstool. So he is putting his foot on earth. He rule because he sits in the heavens, all right? But earth is his footstool, his resting place. The place where his feet is actually resting. We walk with feet. So it is actually our walking out, all right? So our ruler and authority is from the heaven, but our feet is standing on earth, is resting on earth, all right? It is the place where you walk it out. It is actually the manifestation of the authority which is in heaven. You can see that, all right? So if heaven is the throne of God, and earth is his footstool, then this place is the manifestation of his authority. That which we can see. All right, manifest. All right. This is what the Lord says. Heaven is my throne and earth is my footstool. Where is the house you will build for me? So God says through Isaiah to the people, where is the house that you will build for me? Then he says, where will my resting place be? So God's resting place, his foot, is on earth. Where will God put his feet? Where is his footstool? Where will he rest his feet? Verse 2 says, where he will rest his feet. Listen now. So, this is now the footstool. Is it true? Where will I rest my place? Where will the resting place be? Has not my hand made all these things? And so they came into being, declares the Lord. This is the one I esteem. So, the footstool is a person. This is the one where I esteem. Has not my might hand made all these things? Declares the Lord. This is the one I esteem. He who is humble and a contrite in spirit. Contrite means poor in spirit. What is poor in spirit? It's lacking. It's someone that knows you need the Lord. All right. This one I will esteem. Esteem is a good thing. I will look unto him. Where will my resting place be? My feet will rest on a footstool. What is the footstool? It's a one. It's a person. Who is that person? Oh, someone that humbles themselves before the Lord. Listen. And has a contrite spirit. You know you need the Lord. And trembles at my word. Well, so what is the footstool of God? It's people that are humbling themselves before the Lord. I will esteem them. There's no place that you can build for me where I want to dwell. I will do it myself. I will look unto a one, a person, will be a footstool. You see it? All right. Psalm 132 verse 1. And this is now David that's speaking here. Songs is songs. Psalms is songs that someone wrote. And David was a herder, a shepherd. And he wrote many songs. As he looked unto the sheep, he would write songs to the Lord. And this is one song. Listen, yeah. Now, I want you to know, first point, who is the footstool? Someone. Are you that one? Say that to yourself. All right. I want you to hear how that one looks. David sang this song unto the Lord, he says. A song of decrees, decrees. Lord, remember David, all his afflictions, how he swore unto the Lord, vow unto the mighty God of Jacob. So when you make a vow, it means you promise it. You swear unto the Lord. This is what David sang unto the Lord. Surely I will not come into the tabernacle of my house, nor go up into my bed. I will not give sleep to mine eyes, slumber to mine eyelids, until I found out a place for the Lord, a habitation for the Almighty God of Jacob. Wow. This is the heart of David, the song unto the Lord. So where will God rest? He will place his feet on a footstool. The manifestation will be on a footstool. His rulership and authority is in the heavens, but he will manifest it through someone who is humble, contrite spirit, a poor spirit, needy, he knows, and look after the Lord's word. I will esteem that one. David says, Lord, about your dwelling place, I will not let my eyes sleep. I will not go into my house and my tabernacle, my dwelling place and my bed until I build for you a place. So David has something in his heart that's precious. All right. Until I found a place for the Lord, a habitation for the Almighty God. So my second thing that I want to ask you, are you like David, that you will say, Lord, this is very important for me. I will not sleep before I make sure that you have a dwelling place. Amen. All right. So let's say sleep until. Don't sleep. I will not sleep until I see. All right. I will not sleep until I see. First Chronicles, it's now about David, 17 verse 1. So this is now the history. David wrote a psalm little later on. Okay. Now, this is the history. What happened when David and Solomon lived. 17, 1 Chronicles 17, verse 1. It's before the Psalms. So David says, Lord, this is for me important. I will not go into my house nor sleep, close my eyelids, until you have a place. This is for me important. But where does God stay? Where is his feet dwelling? Where is his footstool? A person, a one. A person with a contrite heart, humble spirit. All right. Chronicles 17 verse 1 says, after David was settled in his palace, he said to Nathan the prophet, here I am, living in a palace of cedar, it's wood, while the ark of the covenant of the Lord is under a tent. Do you hear what David is saying? Nathan replied to David, whatever you have in mind, do it, for God is with you. Verse 3, that night the word of God came to Nathan saying, go and tell my servant David, this is what the Lord says, you are not the one to build me a house to dwell in. This is verse 4. Verse 5, I have not dwelt in a house from the day I brought Israel up out of Egypt to this day. I have moved from one tent side to another, from one dwelling place to another. Whatever I've moved with all the Israelites, did I ever say to any of their leaders whom I've commanded to shepherd my people, why have you not built me a house of cedar? So, David has a heart and he says, Lord, I will not sleep. You need a dwelling place. Is that in your heart? But the dwelling place is earth. It is a footstool. It's a man. The Lord asks him and says, to which of the leaders before you have I ever said, you must build me a house? No, no one. Listen. Now then, I tell my servant David, this is what the Lord Almighty says. I took you from the pastures and following the flock to be ruler over my people Israel. I have been with you wherever you have gone, and I've cut off all your enemies from before you. Now I will make your name like the names of the greatest men of the earth. Verse 9, and I will provide a place for my people. I will provide a place for my people, Israel, and I will plant them so that they can have a home of their own and no longer be disturbed. Wicked people will not oppress them anymore, and they did at the beginning, as they did in the beginning. So, hello. Where will you build me a house, says God. You cannot build me a house. But let me tell you, you can help and be the place, the man. Because heaven is my throne, my rulership is here, but I want to rest my feet on earth. Earth has a footstool. That footstool is a man that will manifest my rulership and my presence. It's you that are humble and know that you need me, a contrite spirit, and are focusing on my word. I will esteem you. You cannot bow to me. I have moved with you, David. First Chronicles. I've never said to any of the leaders, they must build me one place. where I'm actually stuck. I will build myself, says the Lord, a place. And now listen, are you the footstool? I will provide the place, says God. I will plant them that they have a home of their own and no longer be disturbed. Hello, so you don't need to be disturbed. Awesome blessing. Wicked people will not oppress you. Know that the wicked people will not oppress you, them anymore, as they did in the beginning. Verse 10, and I have done ever since the time, and have done ever since the time I appointed leaders of my own people, Israel. I will also subdue all your enemies. So, are you that footstool? God will subdue your enemies. I declare to you that the Lord will build a house for you. The Lord will build a house for you. When your days are over, it means when you die, and you go to with be your fathers, David, I will raise up your offspring to succeed you. It speaks of Jesus Christ that will come later. All right. I will raise an offspring to succeed you, one of your own sons, and I will establish his kingdom. He is the one who will build a house for me, and I will establish his throne forever. The Lord never felt this way about Solomon. He's not speaking about Solomon. Solomon sinned. Solomon went after other gods. But the Lord says, when you went to your fathers, meaning into your graves, where they are, you died, I will bring out of your offspring. Jesus is out of the tree of David. All right. So I will make him, and he will build me an house. What house? A house, a footstool. A footstool is a dwelling place. It is not one place. God doesn't want you to have one place where he dwells. He wants many. Because he said to David, I went with you from place to place. Now you want to build me a place of cedar. No, I did not say to you. But let me tell you, there's an offspring and a seed that will come later. He will build me a dwelling place. A footstool, a man, a one that will I esteem, look unto. He is the one who will build the house for me, says the Father. I will establish his throne forever. I will be his father and he will be my son. And I will never take my love away from him. You, I will never take my love away from him. As I took it away from your predecessors. All right, so John 12 verse 1. All right, as you go to John 12 verse 1, I'm going to read a few verses and you must now say to yourself, all right, because it is now like puzzle pieces coming together. All right. So the first thing is I want you to know that anoint the footstool. And the footstool is a place. And it is a place of God, a dwelling place. And it's a place that is moving. He doesn't want one place in one place. All right. Because he said for David, he will build that place. Who is that place? It's a man and a person who honors God's word and has a poor spirit and a humble spirit who will bow before the Lord Jesus Christ. I will look unto him. That will be the footstool. I will take his enemies away. I will give them rest and they will manifest my presence that will be in the heavens. All right. So, John 12 verse 1. Then Jesus, 6 days before the Passover, came to Bethany, where Lazarus was, which had been dead, whom he raised from the dead. You know Lazarus was the friend of Jesus? All right? This is 6 days before Jesus' death. This happening now. 6 days before. Jesus, 6 days before his Passover. 6 days before he died. This happening. Where Lazarus, he came to Lazarus, which was being dead. All right. Whom he raised from the dead. Verse 2. There they made him a supper. And Martha served. But Lazarus was one of them that sat at the table with him. There they made supper and Martha served. But Lazarus was one of them that sat at the table with him, who he raised previously from the dead. Ah. Awesome. Verse 3. Then Mary. Mary is another sister of Martha and Lazarus. She's also with Jesus. Then Mary took about a pint of pure nard. It is an oil, expensive perfume. She poured it out on Jesus' feet and wiped his feet with her hair. And the house was filled with the fragrance of the perfume. Where did she pour it? On the feet of Jesus. Where's Jesus' feet? On the footstool. Where did Mary pour out the oil? On Jesus' feet. Where is Jesus' feet? On the footstool. Heaven is my throne and earth is my footstool. She anointed, pour out very precious oil on the feet of Jesus. All right. Where is Jesus' feet? On earth. What is the footstool? Oh, it's a man. She anoints Jesus' feet. She does not anoint his head. When we anoint people and kings and priests and prophets, we will always throw oil upon their head. Because this is the most precious and important part of the every body part. If you lose your head, you're dead. If you lose an arm, you're all right. If you lose a leg, you're all right. Your feet is important, but not so important. The more important is the head. She did not anoint his head. She anoint his feet. She anoint where his resting place be. She anoint a man, a person. She said, Lord, your feet is walking on this earth. I know you are important, but I understand that you are going to walk now and are going to do something very special. I want to anoint your feet. It's the least important for what you are going to do. So the feet of Jesus represent the manifestation or the walking out of a purpose. She anointed him for a purpose. That's why she anointed his feet. She anointed him for a purpose. Then you anoint the feet, because the feet is walking. It's the acting out. It's the manifestation of what in the heavens is. Heaven is the throne. But my resting place is earth on a footstool. A footstool is a man. When she anoints Jesus' feet, she actually anoints the church, the people that will be hungry, the purpose. It was like she know, Lord Jesus, I know you are the Lord, but I'm going to anoint your purpose. Not you, not your head. You are anointed by the Father, but I want to anoint your work. And your work is a man, is a people that will be contrite spirits. They will honor the word and they will humble themselves. I want to honor that. And my whole focus will be for that. She poured out. And when she, expensive perfume, so it's very expensive. She poured out the oil on Jesus' feet, wipe his feet with her hair. That's amazing. And the house was filled with fragrance of perfume. The whole house was full of perfume. The fragrance of perfume. But one of his disciples, verse 4, Judas Iscariot, who was later to betray him, objected. So one object. Who object? Who object? Judas. Yeah. There's always someone that will object. All right. They will not understand. They will object. Judas object. Judas, who betrayed Jesus later on, object when he saw that Mary anointed Jesus' feet. Why would she do that? Ain't the gospel only about Jesus Christ? Listen, when Jesus died and he lay in the grave, there was an angel at the head of Jesus and an angel, a messenger at the feet of Jesus. A message from God that who Christ will be. He was clothed in a cloth. It needs to be wrapped open so that we can see who Jesus Christ as Lord is. But there was also cloth around his body. Who is the body? The church. And there was a messenger at the feet of Jesus that needs to be opened so that that message will come also to us. Of about what we are. So the gospel has always this two-sided coin. Some will focus a little bit more about Jesus Christ as Lord, and some will focus a little bit on the body side. Who you are in Christ. She poured out a perfume on the body side, on the feet, on the purpose side, on the manifestation side. Because it was very important for her. David says, I will not sleep. I will not go in a tabernacle. I need to build a place. The Lord says, no, I'm going to build a place for you, but you can help with this. Are you the one that has a contrite spirit? A poor spirit? A humble spirit? And do you honor my word? I will look unto you, because that will be the place where my feet. You can help with the anointing there because Mary anointed that place. Is it important for you? Is it important for you that you will take your hair, listen, your hair and dry the feet of Jesus? Will you do that? That's very precious. For a woman, hair is the most precious thing. You must not touch the hair. So sometimes when I pray for people, I will always, if it comes by women, I must, oh Lord, where can I touch them? I must not touch the hair. Because when I'm touching them, they must not think he's touching my hair. So I don't always know where to touch, you know, because the hair. But she says, but the one of the disciples, Judas, says, oh, I object. One of the disciples of Jesus object. People of God, not all people of God will be like that. Some people of God, disciples of Jesus, will object. Luke 7, I want to read that as well for you. Our last scripture. So, you must know you are the footstool. All right. And then, you must have the heart like David says. Lord, this is for me very important. I will not sleep until I see a dwelling place. The Lord will say to you, that's good. That's good. That's good that you will not sleep until you see the dwelling place. But I will build me a home, says God. Luke 7, verse 36. This is also nice. So Mary anoint Jesus' feet. Now this lady was a prostitute. We are reading now about her now. Luke 7 verse 36. Now, yeah. And one of the Pharisees made the request that he would take a meal with him. And he went into the Pharisee's house and took his seat at the table. When a woman who had lived a sinful life in that town learned that Jesus was eating at the Pharisee's house, she brought an alabaster jar of perfume. And, verse 38, and as she stood behind him, Jesus, at his feet, weeping, she began to wet his feet with her tears. Then she wiped them with her hair, kissed them, and poured perfume on them. So here's another lady. First was Mary. She loved Jesus because Mary was the brother of Lazarus, the friend of Jesus. And she poured out this awesome nard oil, perfume. Very, very expensive. If you go in history, they say it's very, very expensive. All right, pour it out upon Jesus' feet. Now, it's another place. Jesus is eating with a friend, all right, listen, a man, a Pharisee. He's not a friend. And a woman, that's not a good woman, a sinner. So let me read this again. And one of the Pharisees made a request that he would take a meal with him, Jesus now. And he went into the Pharisee's house and took his seat at the table. When a woman who had lived in sinful life in that town learned that Jesus was eating at the Pharisee's house, she brought an alabaster jar of perfume. And as she stood behind him at his feet, weeping, she began to wet his feet with her tears. Then she wiped them with her hair, kissed them, and poured perfume on them. So can I write it here? What did she first do? She wet it with her tears. After that, she wet his feet with his hair. Then she wiped them with her hair. And after that, then she wiped them off. And then she kissed his feet. Wow. And then she anointed. She anointed. When the Pharisee, who had invited Jesus, saw this, he said to himself, if this man were a prophet, he would have known who is touching him and what kind of woman she is. That is a sinner. Jesus answered him, Simon, I have something to tell you. Tell me, teacher, he said. Verse 41. Two men owe money to a certain moneylender. One owe him 500 denarii and the other one 50. Neither of them had the money to pay him back. So he canceled the debts of both. Now, which of them will love him the more? Simon replied, I suppose the one who had the bigger debt canceled. You have judged correctly, said Jesus. Then he turned toward the woman and said, verse 44 now, he turned to the woman and said to Simon, do you see this woman? I came into your house. You did not give me any water for my feet. Not water. Water is a regular, natural buyer. Mm-hmm. Huh? Yeah, it's frequent. It is plenty. It's all over. It's not a lot of value. You did not even give me water for my feet. But she wet my feet with her tears and wipe them with her hair. You did not give me a kiss, but this woman, from the time I enter, has not stopped kissing my feet. Wow! You did not put oil on my head, but she poured a perfume on my feet. The best place is to pour oil on Jesus' head, because this is how you anoint people. She took this alabaster box, she broke it open. That perfume, she saved for many, many years about for that. It was her everything. She broke it open upon Jesus' feet. Feet that will walk the ground, that will be full of dust. She will first take her tears. She will kiss his feet, take her hair, wipe his feet, break out. Well, this is a lady. She's a sinful lady. But Jesus says, listen, she knows something. She's like the man that has many sins and owes that man 500 denarii. She knows I will forgive her. But you that have little sin, you do not honor me really. You don't even give me water. You did not pour oil on my head, but she poured perfume on my feet. Jesus said to the woman, verse 50, Jesus said to the woman, your faith has saved you. Go in peace. All right. Ain't this beautiful? It's beautiful. So the last portion of this message that I said is this lady, is it wet hair kiss anoint? Yes, the feet of Jesus. Jesus is an head and a body. The head of Jesus is always him, because we are the body of Christ, the dwelling place of God. Don't you know you are a tabernacle of God? All right? The feet of Jesus is always connected to the body, our part. It's precious. It's less precious than the head, but it's precious. Jesus authorities in the heavens, but he wants to manifest it on earth, on a footstool, on a man. Who is man? We are the men. Lord, I need to see your will be done on earth. I will not sleep to see that you have a dwelling place. I want to build you a place. Now you cannot build me a place. I want to build me places. You are the places. You focus on me, but I'm focusing on you. I want you to manifest me. You are the church. The walking now on earth. Jesus is in the heavens. The head is here in the heavens. We cannot see him, but we can see his church. We can see his feet. Is the church and people as special to you as Jesus? Well, is the feet of Jesus so special to you? Can you see what I'm saying? Is the church very important for you that you will not sleep until you see? Is the church and the people of God so important for you that you wet with tears, take your hair, kiss, anoint, and its feet? All these things with the feet. So many times we will say, Lord, I love you. Then Jesus would say, do you love your brother? Do you love your sister? Lord, I love you. I will do everything for you. The Lord says, hey, will you do it for the brethren? Lord, I will do everything for you, but you cannot even take water and give it to Jesus' feet. Who is Jesus' feet? Who is the footstool? Who is the dwelling place? Who is the manifestation of this Jesus who we love? It's us. Just let me. Can you hear? The church. This must be the church and the kingdom of God. And to influence the kingdom of God must be so important for you as well as Jesus himself. We focus many times on Jesus. We go into a place, a church, and we want to dwell, bless God there. But God says, listen, this is awesome. You want to build me a place, but I will build me a place. It's actually you. And you must walk it out wherever you are going. I don't want you to build me a cedar place or a church. You are the church, the people. I love you. I gave my life for you. I have a sight and a purpose. It's you, it's people. If you say you love Jesus Christ, you need to love me. I need to love you. It is the less. If you can love the less, will you pour out, will you cry, will you take your tears? This is special things, wet with tears, very special. It is very special. Hair, you know, women's hair, very special. Kiss feet, it's special. Anoint with that alabaster box. In history, they say that lady, it was a savings, her, as jy operasie moes nou doodgaan, jy het moes a versekering, wat noem jy dit? Insurance, pay every month, your life insurance. This is what they did with that box. They put, money, whole life savings is in that. She break it open, that perfume. She could have sell it. Because they said, she could have sell it for 300 denarii. It was very, 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 a lot of money that time. And there were disciples, I did not read it now to you, but there were disciples also in this says, why would she do this? We could have sold the perfume and helped many people. Jesus says, leave her alone. She knows she is anointing me for a purpose. And this is just 6 days before he's going to die. For a burial. Let me tell you, Jesus' feet is very important for him. His footstool is very important for him. We need to see the church and will do everything in our mind and power to influence and help the church, help the feet, bless the church. Even if it is your everything, because this, dear, I will not sleep until I see your dwelling place. Do you have the same heart? Oh, the Lord says, I want many dwelling places, but let me tell you, it will not be normal Christians. It will those who will humble themselves. They will have a contrite spirit, broken spirit, a poor spirit, a spirit that says, Lord, we know it's all about you. We need you. And we will honor your word. I will look and esteem that man. Do you hear? This is precious. This is precious. Amen. Make it sense what I'm saying? It's deep then. Make sense. I want to love, huh? Yeah. I want to give everything, but I don't only want to say to the Lord, Lord, I will give you everything. I want to show the Lord. I will do anything for you, whatever, Lord, anything, 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 whatever. You are important for me, and your church is important, your kingdom is important, everything. I will cry, I will take my tears, I will do it physically. I will do it physically. I will take my hair. I do not have long hair, but I will do it, Jesus. I will do it physically. And my whole life, people must say, he will. He will give everything up for the purpose of his feet, to manifest his glory on earth. And I will not sleep to see his dwelling place all over, walking like David said. Mary, she wept. Dry the feet of Jesus, she honors the walking and the thing that Jesus needs to do. That's the man that, let me tell you, that first part of Psalms, where David will say, then I will see the Lord, my enemies. You won't have enemies. What was all those things that he said? He will take care of you truly. Everything for the Lord and for his work, and to Lord, how, what can I do? Let me tell you, I believe when we are going to stand before God and we're going to see him and we're going to see Jesus Christ, you are going to say to yourself, Lord, I wish I have done much more than I've done. I wish I knew who I really was. You are precious. And the Lord, by this, what I've read here, shows how precious you are. He wants to anoint you and use all these special things on you. Because Jesus cried as well. And I believe he will also take his hair. Well, one day the disciples were there and Jesus says, come here, I'm going to wash your feet. Ish. Peter says, no, there's no way. Lord, you will not wash my feet. Then Jesus says, listen, I want to wash your feet. Then he had this thing. All right, Lord, wash my head. And the Lord says, no, it's only necessary to wash your feet. I want to wash your feet. And after that, he said to them, you must do the same. So, let me tell you, when I see Tani Sue, I must see Jesus. Whatever I want to do for Jesus, I can do for Tani Sue. And in that, I do it for Jesus. If you say you love me, you love his church, you love the kingdom, you love people, then it shows it is the manifestation where the feet of Jesus is, or what he is. And I believe we are going to see a lot of miracles because his authority is in the heavens, but he wants to manifest it here. And that song that other guy sang, we all know one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord, we are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. And together we are united as Christians. And this is how the world will know we are Christians, by our love, by our love. Amen. Let's love people. I know we can judge them. Some people, you're in South Africa, you won't understand this now. My friend there in the United States or Canada. Yeah, in South Africa, you want to the people here. But we need to say, Lord, forgive them. We will love the people. We will help. We will do special things to show that God must do something special for His church. Amen. Be blessed in Jesus' mighty name.